My name is Erin Purcell. I'm a postdoc in the Microbiology and Immunology department at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill. What I work on here is studying how the intestinal pathogen Clostridium difficile, which is a hospital-acquired infection, senses and responds to changes in its environment. Well, I grew up in Maine. I really first became interested in science in ninth grade in debate team, actually, because we were given a debate scenario about discrimination against people with genetic diseases. And I was really, really interested once I got to high school chemistry and was just learning how stuff works, how the matter in the universe works. It just kind of blew my teenage mind. That was what really led me into science. And then I also wanted to be doing something useful, so that led me into studying bacteria that cause diseases, and C. diff specifically. C. diff was actually named as a pun. It's named Clostridium difficile because it's very difficult to work with. So we actually don't know very much about it, considering what an important human pathogen it is. It can go dormant and become unstoppable. And so that's why it persists in environments for so long, because C. diff can form these spores. It produces protein toxins that shred the linings of our intestines, and that causes the bloody diarrhea and sometimes death. People on antibiotics and people who are elderly and immunocompromised who are really at risk for this disease. And the CDC recently reclassified it as an urgent threat. It costs about $3 billion a year in the US and is implicated in about 29,000 deaths a year. Well, a lot of what I'm doing is, well, basically poking the bacteria with a little stick and seeing what happens. Sometimes it's by knocking out a gene and seeing what it does in response to that external change. We are looking at C. diff in actually two different forms of its life cycle. If you look here, the spores are what's called phase bright, which are almost sort of reflective, and they're very easily distinguished from the long, dark vegetative cells. But the vegetative cells that they germinate into are the ones that secrete toxins and actually cause symptomatic infections. One of the main tools we use in the lab is that we've built genetic systems to artificially raise or lower the amount of cyclic IgMP in bacteria. And because raising and lowering their levels of cyclic IgMP is one of the main ways they respond to environmental changes and sort of resist environmental changes, like the changes we cause when we take antibiotics or change our diets, when we interfere with their ability to do that, we interfere with their ability to survive changes. I like to solve puzzles, and I personify the puzzles a little bit so that I have to win against them. If my experiments aren't working, then, you know, C. diff is winning. It's probably not that healthy, but it's really motivating. Just talking things out with other people is very helpful to think, oh, I haven't considered this, or someone else pointing out, have you thought about that? So that's a really good way to get past roadblocks. Talking about the things you'd like to do and seeing what other people find the most interesting is a good way to figure out what your priorities should be for the experiments you're planning. Everything we find out is something new. So that's really fun. You know, on a really good day, the human race knows slightly more than it did when I went into work in the morning, and that's incredibly satisfying. We don't get those good days every day or every week, but the good ones are really good. The big picture is coming up with better treatments for C. diff, and the huge picture is coming up with a better understanding of how the bacteria living in us shape and promote our health, and how we can work with that. I'm in this because I like solving puzzles and getting a little bit obsessive about them and figuring out exactly how they work, and then moving on to a new puzzle, so I can't really imagine being satisfied doing anything else.